Mein Name ist Matthias Birkicht, ich bin beschäftigt am Zentrum.
My name is Matthias Birkicht. I work at the Center for Tropical Marine Ecology in Bremen. I'm currently on board the research ship Meteor, along with my research group from the biogeochemistry subproject with Anita Flohr and Tim Rixen. I'm working on nutrient analysis, which is a basic parameter for the evaluation of nutrient flows in the ocean. Water, the elixir of life, contains nutrients which, here in the Benguela upwelling system, are transported upwards from the seabed by cold ocean currents. The nutrients include phosphorus as phosphate, nitrite, nitrate, and ammonium. As nitrogen components, and the silicon important for diatoms. The algae on the ocean's surface consume the nutrients transported upwards and, in doing so, feed the organisms further up in the food chain. In order to research the distribution of these nutrients in the water column on the seabed and in the sediment, we use a variety of devices on the Meteor. One device which samples the different depths in the water column is the CTD rosette. This is the CTD rosette. In the center, it contains a physical measuring unit which records temperature, conductivity, and depth. As soon as the CTD rosette is lowered into the water, we are able to close each of the 14 individual water samplers so that they retain the water that is scooped up, bringing it to the surface. After the rosette has completed the journey to just above the seabed and all the samplers have been closed, the CTD rosette is lifted back onto the deck. Now we have sampled almost the entire water column with the CTD. The 1 meter above the seabed presents a problem because the CTD rosette cannot be placed on the seabed. For this, we use a very special device, the bottom water sampler. The bottom water sampler has 5 Niskin bottles, arranged in parallel at different levels, which are first opened and then remain cocked and ready. As soon as the bottom water sampler rests gently on the seabed, the lids of the Niskin bottles close and seal the water from the seabed in the bottles. Now, all that's missing is the seabed. The seabed consists of marine sediment and particles loosely bound to each other, which contain pore water. Just above the seabed, we have the supernatant water. In order to collect the supernatant water and the pore water, we need a special instrument, the multicorer. The multicorer works with core cutters, which are fixed into the mount. When the multicorer reaches the seabed, the weight rams the core cutters into the seabed and gathers a sediment core with supernatant water. The tubes are firmly closed at the top and bottom, and the Multicorer is lifted onto the deck. Now I'm in the laboratory with all my samples, which I transfer into the sample injector on the auto-analyzer. For each individual nutrient to be analyzed, we need reagents. These reagents are mixed with the sample in the system. As a reaction takes time, we have long spirals where the sample can react with the reagent. During the reaction, a color develops which is specific to each of these individual nutrients: nitrate, nitrite, ammonium, phosphate, and silicate. We will simulate one of the color reactions for the nutrients in this test tube. We add the reagent to the sample, and the reaction takes place. The analyzer can accurately determine the concentration of the nutrient based on the intensity of the color.